Trick or treat.
Trick or treat.
Trick or treat. Trick
or treat. Kids are perfecting their greeting before they take on the town to fill their candy baskets. This is the second Halloween in the pandemic, but this year, kids and their families are encouraged to participate in the festivities.
Trick or treating would really bring some spirit back to us.
This year marks a turning point since the FDA issued the vaccine for emergency use authorization for children ages 12 to 15. Coronavirus cases in the United States are on the decline, especially for people who are vaccinated. According to the CDC, more than 76% of children in that age group have received at least one dose, and more than 66% are fully vaccinated.
And although there have been inroads made by masking and doing other things, we're still not where we need to be for children to be able to grow up and have a full childhood and all the way through adolescence.
The FDA plans to consider Pfizer's request to authorize its vaccine for young children in late October.
I see this as urgent for many reasons, the social reasons as well as the immediate impact in reducing hospitalizations and illness.
According to Pfizer, one third of the dose given to adults and teens is safe in children as young as five.
That we're going to be submitting to the FDA that demonstrates a robust immune response and a satisfactory safety profile for the Pfizer BioNTech mRNA vaccine in children.
Many parents and kids are eager for the vaccine to get approved.
If I have the chance to become vaccinated, then COVID could end or it could just get better and me and my friends could hang out more.
If we were fortunate enough to have Maya vaccinated, it would add an extra layer of protection.
If vaccination for this group is approved, it could help protect more than 28 million people in the United States. Then greater protection could be achieved for the overall population. Halloween is around the corner, and being outdoors is the safer choice. Dr. Anthony Fauci gave trick-or-treaters the green light to go ahead and enjoy it because of the low risk of spreading the virus outside.
It would be a good idea to take some hand sanitizer with you trick-or-treating and helping your kids frequently sanitize, especially if they want to sneak a treat before they get home.
Halloween's about wearing masks, right?
But wearing a mask during Halloween is a little different from any other day. Children may have trouble breathing if they wear both a costume mask and a COVID mask together.
But in between houses, if they take their costume mask off, putting their mask on while they're traveling in that group is a good idea.
Different communities may have different rules, but no matter how you choose to participate, the CDC reminds people to social distance when possible and follow safety guidelines.
Even though outside, we'll probably do masks, but other than that, I think it's going to be a pretty normal trick-or-treating year, which I'm very excited about.
We're planning on sitting out in the front yard and maybe just putting candy along the fence so the kids can just grab it.
Some things may look different, but the spirit remains the same.
And everything that's been different had a purpose, but we can give them a little bit of normalcy. They deserve it.
Not only will kids celebrate the spooky holiday this year, they also return to the classroom with some stipulations.
Really have to do it. The goal is really to keep schools in person without any kind of home learning, without any kind of distance learning, because children have suffered. So the fact is, it has to be the default that schools stay open.
To take matters a step further, California is the first state to require eligible students to be vaccinated for in-person learning.
Once the FDA approves the vaccination in different cohorts, starting with 12 and above, grades 7 to 12, we will begin to apply that requirement in the next term.
Other states set different policies on vaccination and whether students and staff are required to wear masks. We are gradually returning to normal. To check if you're in an area of substantial or high transmission levels, please visit cdc.gov.